Study arata. In the last few years, people from all over the world have successfully learned new subjects quickly by using a four-step method known as the Feynman Technique. This way of study was created by Richard Feynman, who won the 1965 Nobel Physics Prize for his studies in quantum electrodynamics. There is nothing new about the Feynman Technique, but this method has become very popular in recent times, and one of the people responsible for this renewed interest in this study method is Elon Musk, one of the most inventive and controversial and successful entrepreneurs in our recent history. To get an idea of how this technique works, you need to understand that Feynman was a person who was critical of the way that most people study, by prioritizing memorizing over reasoning. Feynman stressed that knowing the name of the thing is very different from knowing the thing itself. And it was to correct that mistake of memorizing instead of learning that Feynman developed a simple four-step method for students to learn any concept better. The idea is that the students unpack an idea in a simple way and then to understand and rebuild that same idea. The Feynman technique adapts to the brain's way of learning. The main reason the Feynman technique yields excellent results is that it is aligned with the way that our brain works. Instead of focusing on memorizing concepts and names and dates and numbers, this method prioritizes a deep, true understanding of the topic. In order for you to say that you've gained a deep understanding of a given topic, you need to be able to explain that topic to other people. And this works because only somebody with a deep understanding of a topic is able to explain to other people what they know about it. Think, for instance, of a topic of which you are an expert. Maybe it could be one of your academic subjects, could be a hobby, anything. You probably can explain that topic to other people, right? Now, think of a topic in which you are not an expert. Quantum electrodynamics, for example. Do you think you could teach, right now, quantum electrodynamics to other people? Probably not. Even if you manage to memorize a few basic concepts, it is quite safe to say that if you try to teach these ideas to other people, they wouldn't understand the thing. And that is why the Feynman technique works so well. The method allows you to gain such a good understanding of the topic that then you're able to explain it as if you would be a teacher on that subject. The four steps to learn anything with the Feynman technique. To implement the Feynman technique, you need to follow four simple steps. First, you need to pick a topic. Then, you need to teach this topic to a child. And thirdly, you need to identify the flaws, the gaps in your understanding. And finally, you need to reveal and simplify what you've already learned. Sounds easy? When people hear about a study method that was invented by a Nobel Prize winner who was working with quantum electrodynamics, they immediately think it's going to be very complicated, something out of reach. But one of the strengths of the Feynman technique is actually its simplicity. So, let's now go through each one of these four steps separately. Remember, you're always going to need pen and paper to practice this method. And step number one is to choose a topic. Step one, choose a topic. The first step is to clearly define what you want to learn. For this first step, try to be very specific. Don't choose something very broad like mathematics. Instead, go for a topic with a narrower focus, like combinatorial analysis. You can even be more specific and choose just one concept within the topic of combinatorial analysis. Then, take a sheet of paper and write down your chosen topic at the top. Then, write down everything you know about that topic on that sheet of paper. You can use an extra page if you need to, but ideally, the topic should be so specific that it's not going to take you more than just a couple of pages. Every time you learn something new, as we go through these next steps of the Feynman technique, you're going to add that piece of knowledge to your notes. Now, be sure to make notes using your own words. This is very important. never copy instructions or sentences from books, from your teachers, from the internet. Don't use technical jargon. Use your own words. And step number two, teach the chosen topic to a child. The second step in the Feynman technique is to teach these ideas, the chosen topic, to a child. Take your page of notes and start explaining that topic to a child. Ideally, you really have a 7 to 10-year-old child in front of you. And in case that is not an option, you can pretend you're teaching an imaginary child that idea. The most important thing is not really the physical, real presence of a child, but your ability to explain that topic in simple terms that even a child would understand. And to do that, you're going to not use jargon. You're going to use your own words. You're going to focus on the founding principles of your chosen topic. Of course, the child won't understand you perfectly, especially if you're dealing with a very advanced topic. But the focus of this second step should be on what you're teaching, not on what the child is actually learning. At the end of the day, you are the person who's going to be studying. So at the end of your explanation, you're going to notice that probably you didn't understand a few topics very well. And these are the points that we're going to use in the step number three. Step three is to identify the gaps in your understanding. Based on this explanation that you're giving to this child, you're going to make notes about what are the parts of the topic that you need to understand better. Write down where are these gaps in your understanding. And then you can go back to your books and you can learn these parts again. Add every new thing that you learn and new pages in your notes. This is a very important step. It is the core of this study technique. The details of the topic that you found most challenging to explain, these are the ones, the aspects that you need to cover again and study harder. The parts that you already managed to explain clearly to the child are already okay. They don't require a lot of revision. You already have a very good understanding of those parts. What you need to do now is to focus on the parts where you're still lacking a deep understanding. This optimizes your time and it helps you to prioritize what you study correctly. It's also going to save you time from making the mistake of staying in a comfort zone, already going over what you already know. Don't do that. And ideally, after reviewing the topic, you should be able to explain these ideas to the child once again and then check if the gaps in your understanding have been filled. This is the main concept of the Feynman technique. When you can explain that topic to a child, it means that you really learned what you're trying to study. And here is step number four, review and simplify. The final step in the Feynman technique is to review your work and simplify the language even further. Now you're going to write down what you've learned in your own words. One more time, avoid using jargon, technical terms that you're copying from the books, from the teachers. Write it in your own words, in simple terms that you can use in your day-to-day interactions. If it's necessary, use analogies with actions from your daily routine to further deepen your understanding. Try to produce a logical text that can be read aloud. If you can identify new gaps in your understanding while you're doing this, what you're going to do? You go back to step number three, and then you review the topic one more time. Use the Feynman technique as another tool for your studies. Imagine how would you be performing in your studies, or maybe in your career, if you could be learning new things quickly, efficiently. That's doable if you start practicing the Feynman technique and using it as another tool in your study hacks. And to achieve that, remember the standard to determine whether you've really learned something or not is your ability to explain the topic in simple terms, so simple that even a child would be able to understand you. Now, let's go over the four steps of this technique. Choose one specific subject, explain it to a child, identify the gaps in your understanding, and then review and simplify. If you think that this technique is very basic, remember it was developed decades ago by a Nobel Prize winner, and it has stood the test of time. The Feynman technique is a way of studying that optimizes your time and it is really efficient. The technique works as it is aligned with the way the human brain learns. First, you're going to unpack ideas and then you're going to build the same ideas again, but using your own words. That being said, you shouldn't take this method as the only solution to all your study problems. Instead of creating that kind of expectation. Think of this technique as just one more tool that you can use and learn new things quickly and efficiently. And if you want to learn about other techniques to learn even faster, now you can take a look at our course, How to Learn Faster, by visiting arata.se/howtolearn.